I'm a paediatrician who received his training in the 80s and 90s, and back then very little was known in Australia about FASD. In about the mid-2000s, I was working in an outpatient clinic, and a very lovely lady with two children in her foster care came into my clinic. And I said, "How can I help you?" And she said, "I think these children have FASD." And I said to her, "What's that?" Unfortunately though, when I tried to find some training in FASD, none was available in Australia. And indeed, the only way we could source training was to go overseas to Vancouver, Canada. And that started our journey as a team in the diagnosis of FASD, and we first opened our clinic in 2014. Between 2000 and 2013, we only diagnosed one child with FASD. Since 2014, we've diagnosed over 100. And the people haven't changed. The tools that we use haven't changed, but what has changed is our knowledge and our skill base about FASD.
So we've got the Gold Coast Clinic that Doug Shelton started, Westmead Children's Hospital Clinic that
I think there's definitely a role for better education and training around FASD, and that's for people who are already health professionals. But I also think that basic modules on FASD should be incorporated into every university course that is to do with health. So that would include allied health in all their various forms, nursing and medicine.
What else have you been doing today? You been having fun?
Yeah.
FASD needs to come out of the closet and make it a topic of mainstream conversation in a similar way to what happened with autistic spectrum disorder in the 90s and in the last few years.
Yeah, another high five. Oh, what about a proper one?